Picture we have already started the last chapter. Hello, my voice is audible. Is the screen visible? The introduction to the last chapter. Before that, we give brief introduction. Protein technology, will include the surface engineering. We discuss about what is surface engineering, will its purpose, different types of surface modification, like surface coating, how it will be achieved. Then we see the principle of different processes which we use in surface coating. And then we see the what is actually meant by surface coating. There are different advanced methods. Those are utilized for deposition of the coating, like thermal spraying, Golden technique, PVD, PVD. Then we discuss in detail thermal and plasma spraying. PVD, that is a physical vapor deposition, then chemical vapor deposition. Whatever the selection of the surface treatment method, it will be mainly changing the property. The material of the substrate we are using, characteristics, thickness of the process will flow as fast type of the process. Definitely the requirement of the vacuum, geometric component, and cost. These are the certain parameters you must try to consider for selecting any kind of the surface treatment. Now we discuss about the first type, that is physical vapor decomposition, that is the PVD. So the method of surface coating technique. We in this lecture we discuss about the what is the PVD, how it will be classified, and certain types according to classification, that is evaporation, electron evaporation, reactive electron evaporation, these are certain types. As far as this physical vapor decomposition method is to be considered, it mainly involves the ejection of the material physically as in the form of atoms or molecules. In physical vapor decomposition method, you can melt that material in a vapor phase, and they are allowed that vapor is ejected on a material in the form of atoms or molecules. After that, we have to carry out cooling called as condensation and nucleation of these atoms or molecules on the substrate, that is the workpiece, over which we have to provide the metal cooling. The vapor film material, it can consist of ions or plasma, and that is reacted chemically with the gases that was introduced into this paper. So that process is called as a reactive deposition of the compounds. Such PVD, that is the physical vapor deposition method, such process can be applied to various kind of these ceramics, polymers, different metallic alloys, and composite. This will be the diagram. It will show the physical vapor deposition structure or setup. With the source material, we have to melt it in place of crucible with heating unit. We have to melt this is centrifugal. We have to maintain certain vacuum in this processing chamber. Because of that, whatever the metal, by taking this in coil, will be get metal. This vapor will be detected on the sample. Okay, is it clear?
Whether my voice is audible clearly? Is it visible?
Yes, reply please. Is it visible? Voice is audible? Yes, Girish. Am I audible? Amol? Amol Nagane? Are you there?
Yes, sir. Audible.
Next, we have to classify typical vapor deposition method in a following manner: thermal evaporation, electron beam evaporation, the reactive or activated reactive. Electron beam evaporation, sputtering, filter cathodic arc evaporation, ion plating, and last one that is pulsed laser deposition. These are the classification of the typical vapor deposition. What are these classifications? First type of the particle and the thermal evaporation, head structure in the air, the fuel containing target material, vapor surface from the product element, vacuum generated in the product for pumping system, the substrate that will be mounted by the substrate holder. Level, that we can provide even the 160 where we maintain sufficient vacuum in the thermal evaporation, which will use the thermal evaporation, which is an electric resistance in order to melt the source material. Source material of carbon material will be melted by the heating coil. And by this, the vapor pressure whatever the thermal energy, it is converted to the ions, liquid or solid. So that it can efficiently evaporate this process. This evaporation is going to take place in a vacuum. And generally 10 raised to minus 4, 10 raised to minus 6 torr. Torr is a unit of the electric. That much stress to be able to maintain in a vacuum chamber. The evaporated particles, it may be ions or molecules, can be traveled directly to the towards the deposition target. Stop colliding with the backup gas. The coating film can also be co-evaporated using the multiple. There are different types of such thermal evaporation according to the input energy we are providing. So, inductivity, or we may use a laser beam or laser evaporation beam. Right? These are all about the thermal evaporation process. Thermal process is to be conductive. Are you getting this? This slide will focus on thermal evaporation process, how it is depicted. How much capital needs to be maintained, and we show the diagrammatically how the process is to be there is some advantages, disadvantages, and applications for electric energy. Such process is a simple and cheap. Less surface damage on the substrate is going to happen. Whatever the film that will be produced on substrate, that will have excellent purity. These are the advantages. As far as the disadvantages are concerned, the thermal evaporation process will be limited to low melting point meter. It provides more density, more energy. It is not possible to evaporate the dielectric material by using thermal evaporation. There will be limits for the filament or the amount of material that can be evaporated. It will stop the coverage. It is more difficult to the state coverage is more difficult in the thermal evaporation process. That is part of one type of what will be now, what are the applications of this thermal evaporation? We will use it for the evaporation of semiconductors and insulators. Mainly, it will be utilized in gold plating. We can optimize this process for purity of the film, that is different, purity of the source material, and quantity of the spectrum or quality of the. In case of the film, this thickness of film may vary according to the geometry of the chamber. Means if you have changed the geometry, you can change the vacuum according to the impact on the thickness of the metal coating over the substrate or substrate. Right now, advantages, disadvantages, and application part. Evaporation. You may draw this diagram. It's a sufficient time for the diagram and the description of the thermal evaporation process. write down advantages and disadvantages and applications of community audio. Next type of a PVD is electron beam. That's the part of the PVD. Here only the source of the heat between the engine instead of the heating coil, we can use the electron. This is the target material in crucible. And whatever the purpose will be found, that will be deposited on substrate. Anode, which is called as target, is bombarded with the electron beam, which will give you a charged tungsten filament on the anode. This is the anode, which is the target filament, which will be bombarded with the electron beam. What is the atom from target transformation into the cathode state? Atoms then precipitated into the solid form that will produce the coating or substrate with a thin layer of anode material. Right. What are the advantages to high as well as low deposition rate? I mean 2 micrometer per minute. Have adequacy to control structural as well as morphological properties of this coating. This process is being utilized in aerospace, surface cutting industries, electronics and optical field, where are usually in semiconductor. In the evaporation process, which is having the certain disadvantages that there will be possibly a filament degradation that will happen due to the non-uniform evaporation rate. Also, there will be possibility of extreme of the vapor cloud. There will be certain limitations. It will be all about the electron beam evaporation process, which is the one of the type by which we can carry out physical vapor deposition. Read this slide, mark some important points among the advantages and disadvantages of the nuclear drug diagram related to this problem.
voice is audible? You can write your roll number in chat box of the attendance. Everybody have written their roll number in chat box. Nobody is remaining. I repeat, nobody is remaining. Now it's all about the healing from the pure patient or in short it will be healing. The third type that is a reactive and activated reactive healing from the operation. The purpose of such pure operation process is to form certain kind of healing from this. So it's mainly used the part of refractory oxide, carbide, both are under the word segmentation. That will result in stoichiometry to be different from the initial material. In order to overcome such situations, we have to use reactive or activated reactive cooperation that must be used. For electron beam, that is called E beam, and thermal cooperation process are used for the reactive deposition. The advantage of this method by using such kind of process, the deposition of oxide or compound will be possible. This is the reactive evaporation process oxidizing by using the reactive type, the reactive gas is produced in the chamber by the metal. Gases we may use the oxygen, nitrogen, or hydrogen. With the thermodynamic conditions are met. At that time, the metal ions that are reacting with the gas that will come into the vicinity of the constant and form the heat till the metal could be for the gas. It's all about the reactive and the reactive. Activated reactive electron beam. I read this slide on an important point. The reactive beam is a reactive beam. Then activated reactive type. This process it is have two points and that will be utilized to enhance the reaction efficiency and also it will use to modify the growth kinetics and hence structure morphology of this inequalities. The plasmas are to be used to activate the reactive gas in case of the activated reactive type. Source of the evaporation, it may be an electron beam or a resistive heating force. Such kind of the process will be used in titanium oxide, silicon oxide as an hardening coating, and it mainly a chamber in manufacturing of carbide and nitride. Carbide coating or coating coating or will provide that coating of the nitride. Second part, it will be focusing on filtering cathodic arc deposition. Insert cathodic arc deposition, ion plating, and first layer to decomposition. Now, filtering. Filtering is one of the methods, one of the types of physical method. There are different steps that we have to follow when carrying out the filtering operation. In this process, first step is to gather the target material and such that it must be necessary. First step, we have to apply a voltage between target that we will connect with the immediate terminal so it will work out the cathode. And the substrate that will be provided. Positive supply will be electrical. And what is the third step in which plasma is created? The process of ionizing of this filtering gas. The gas so that usually argon used as a filtering gas because it is a chemical inert in nature. Fourth step. Whatever the atoms or molecules from the target material, they are going to eject into the gas and they will form the plasma. It will be the environment of this filtering gas. In step number 5, this ejected target material, they will be deposited on the substrate. So, metallic coating will be formed by using the target material on a substrate. There are certain advantages of this process. That is, this particular process where the material goes on having a higher melting point. Such kind of the metal can be easily exported. The film produced by sputtering or adhesion to the substrate that you are using. Whatever coating it will be formed on the substrate or working by using this sputtering process. It has a good adhesion property as compared to the sputtering. One of the disadvantages of this process. Next, putting gas in arc built into the growing film has a steam. Whatever the gas we are using for the putting purpose, that is chemically in the way. The gas is going to build growing film that will be formed up. It will build film that will be formed in this putting of the metal over the. This is the diagram which shows the process of this filtering. This is the chamber. Filtering gas is provided over here. The anode. So, we have substrate. Right? And that neutral are not the footprint process that we don't have for the physical vehicle condition. Correct some of the important points in the process and we have identified the several values and the estimate we have about this process. Is it clear on this process? Have you understood? Cathodic arc dispositioning. In this process, whatever the arc that will be generated because the unit is used to vaporize the material from the target. The target is then acted as a cathode. Whatever the vaporized material then allowed to cool or condense on substrate that will form the coating. Cathodic arc that will be take a special place among these physical vapor decomposition process because in this method there will be possibility of high iron density. This arc vaporization occurs in high current, low voltage. That was placed between two cathodes. This cathodic arc deposition process will be extremely hard. That will be extremely hard. Therefore, can be used for deep hard film, super hard coating, or nano coating. It can be used to deposit metallic as well as ceramic and film. These are observed in this diagram. They are providing power supply, spectrum, and cathode. Allowed to convey so that coating will be produced on the substrate. The next step that is the filtered cathodic arc deposition. In this process, kind of process so that it should be used in tribological variation. Mainly it eliminates the macro particles. The macro particles are the large size that degrade good performance. Unwanted macro particles and neutral atoms are filtered out by using certain kind of mechanical filter. And coating stages reaching the substrate are clear. This is all about the filtered cathodic deposition. The next method is the ion plating. In ion plating, no doubt we require the vacuum. It is an atomistic vacuum coating process where there will be position of the film continuously carried out. This is a theoretically bombardment type of energetic atomic size inert or reactive particle. So that this process is also called as an ion IUD or ion vapor deposition, IUD. Ion plating process can be called as an ion assisted deposition or ion vapor deposition. As we discussed that activated reactive evaporation process. That we have discussed. That was with the negative bias on the substrate called the reactive ion plating. Then we have conducting this activated reactive evaporation in reverse manner, which are called as the reactive ion plating. The mechanism of this ion plating will consist of first the concentration, second nucleation and interface information. This is the block diagram that we showed the ion plating. Source of this depositing atoms can be formed vacuum evaporation by using deposit, or it will be obtained by the arc vaporization, or it will form the chemical vapor pressure also. It will actually get support and this is application. The dielectric and ferroelectric films can be produced by pulse. this is the summary of this physical vapor decomposition. These chemical reactions are not involved except for the reactive protein formation. This is protein deposition process of this reaction of chemical reaction. There was a certain approach for this physical vapor decomposition data, controllable growth of chemicals with high priority. There will be a chance of improvement in the repeatability and the reliability of the modified process. Most of the cases, the instruments are highly precise or less costly. The modification techniques can be applied in various fields like manufacturing, industrial workers, biological coating. Aerospace industry, you can widely use physical vapor decomposition process as a motor for it. Are you getting? So, in this book, in today's lecture, we have covered the physical vapor deposition process, working principle, classification, and we have separately classify or describe each of which one of the type of this classification of physical vapor deposition. Are you getting? If you have any doubt related to this part, please ask. अडचण आहे याच्यामध्ये Amol, are you there? Amol? Girish?
Yes, sir.
Okay, have you clear all the types of the physical vapor deposition process? Some of the types process?
Yes, sir.
Okay, okay, thank you. Now we'll come for here. In next lecture, we will discuss about the revenue part of it.